Lithium Flow is supposed to be Gemini 3.0, and we are going to try to get it to create a self-park episode using just SVGs. So we can see two versions here. The right one looks terrible. Try the left one, and it looks a lot better. We can actually see what it looks like. Let's just open this up in a new tab. This is one single prompt that generated this. I honestly don't think either is Gemini 3 because I think it can do it better. And the left one was GPT-5, but we can do this better. You can see our prompt up here. We're going to try to get Gemini 3.0. So on the right here, we have something that's going on. I don't know exactly what. Let's open the left one in a new tab. We want this like full screen. I'm actually going to zoom in a little bit. We're going to just go like that. So we have a nice little play button. We have a restart button and we can see our time, and it is running self-park SVG edition. And this looks really good. Dude, this bus is taking forever. Yeah, I'm freezing. And this was one single prompt. Okay, keep in mind, there might be things that are wrong, like his eyes, but nonetheless, compare this to the output of other ones that we've seen. So there's our UFO coming in. It is really, really good. This is wild. And we have a little story. So we have the UFO, he's beaming down, and
5 minutes later,
slowly but surely, he's getting there. He's walking over. Kenny, don't touch that. And, you know, Kenny's going to be beamed up into the UFO. Oh, nope, never mind. I should have saw that coming. I don't know why I didn't. So, anyway, you can see here, this is a full-fledged one-minute video made out of SVGs. And we can actually just replay it, and it just works. So, based off these two, I'm going to say the left one is better, and the left one has to be Lithium Flow. And just for reference, the right one is Claude Sonnet 4.5. This is Claude Sonnet 4.5. This is the state-of-the-art coding model that exists right now, and this is what we have versus Lithium Flow. Lithium Flow is supposed to be Gemini 3.0, but without Google search grounding. There's also a wrong mist, but that's supposed to be with Google search grounding. Lithium Pro is supposed to be the Google 3.0 Pro model that they're testing on LM Arena that you can try right now yourself for free. You're going to want to go to web.lmarena.ai. You're going to see something that looks like this. So maybe you want a gamified task manager. You can put in whatever prompt you want. And truthfully, the prompt I put in, I got from this person on Twitter. So this is where I got the idea from. And I literally generated my own version of it. This is what his looked like. You can see what mine looked like. It was really good. But anyway, you're going to come here. You're going to see two generate, one on the left, one on the right. It's not going to tell you which model is which. Once it's done generating, you pick which one's better. And then it'll tell you, hey, these are the models that you just compared. So in our last example, we compared Claude 4.5 with the newest unreleased version of Gemini 3.0 Pro. And the difference was night and day. So benchmarks, for example, we have King Bench, and we can actually see here what it scores and how well it does. So we have 3.0 Pro, which scores 91, and then we have different versions of it, 87. The Lithium Flow model that we're playing around with is only at 83%, and these are all the different models that they've been able to benchmark. In comparison to Sonnet 4.5, and Sonnet is a fantastic model, let's just say that, that scores 62%, versus like the 83% that we are using on this model here, or all the way up to 91%, which is absolutely wild considering, again, how good Claude Sonnet actually is. But benchmarks mean nothing if it doesn't actually produce anything good. So let's start off with SVGs. It is very good at SVGs. The first example here is a car exploding into different parts. And this is just one prompt. So you can actually see the separation level. They literally drag it back and forth, and you can see the car going into different parts or coming back into a single car. This is absolutely insane. It is able to do this with this level of detail and accuracy. You can take the same exact concept, but use a drone. And this one here that I have playing for you, the one on the right, this is Claude Opus 4.1. There's not a lot happening here. It's just, yeah, it's just stationary. Okay. Now let's go look at this one here. And this is Lithium Flow. So this is wild. Once again, it just kind of expands and comes back. You can see all the parts. The parts get labeled as it expands out. It is wild. It is night and day different. Do you know the Pelican riding the bike challenge? Well, this is what it looked like back in May. You ask the AI, hey, can you make a Pelican riding a bike and turn it into an SVG? So you can see Claude Sonnet 4, Opus 4, and 2.5 Pro preview. But here is Lithium Flow, and this is what it looks like now. This is substantially better than anything we had in the past. All right, coming back to our example here that we generated, this was like the gamified version of a task list. So the left was grok code fast. It didn't generate anything. And on the right, we have Lithium Flow, which created like an entire quest system with XP. You can see it expand up. We completed these quests. We can enter something new. We can give it some points. So let's just like enter some stuff so I can actually check it off. I want to see myself level up. You know, I'm going to feel good. Look at that, level 2. I'm getting fireworks and everything. It is just phenomenal. It always creates high quality code, high quality websites, SVGs, little animations. It's just insane how good this is. And then we have grok code fast, which doesn't even work. So while we're waiting for this to finish, let's look at a game. So this is an escape room created by Lithium Flow. Again, one prompt, it's able to make these styled games. It's making a full-fledged escape room that you can actually play. So you can see the log, you can see you're collecting like inventory, you're going back and forth, you're trying to figure out all the clues, and you're trying to actually escape from this game. So you can go into the power grid and you're activating little things, you're clicking buttons. It makes a full-fledged escape room game. Sticking on the game theme for a minute, we have this game here, which is actually on CodePen, so we can actually click and play ourselves. So WSD to move, and we have to bonk all of them. It just automatically starts bonking for us. We have XP that we can collect. As I get closer to the XP, I can collect it automatically. Ooh, we can level up. So let's update our... Ooh, this is wild. Okay, this is one prompt. Keep that in mind. And I am actually having fun playing this. And let's see if we can get another upgrade or two. And I wonder what happens when we... Like, does it give us a new... Oh, look, it gives us new upgrades each time. So we can do, like, rapid fire, and we can just bonk quicker. So let's try to avoid all these. And let's try one more time. Let's try to go where all these green are. We're going to try to get all of our XP power-ups. I don't want to lose my health yet. And let's do another multi-shot. That's giving me 3 now. Yep. Yeah, 3 shots now. Okay. So it does indeed work. So let's do rapid fire again.
5 minutes later.
Just kind of want to see what I can do as I level up and what I can actually gain. But we have a video to shoot, so let's get out of this. And you can see my time at the top. Up next on the list of things I want to show you is a one-shot near-perfect Gmail UI clone. So let's click here. You can actually see the left one is off. The right one, Lithium Flow, as always, is on the task. We can see labels. We can see the inbox, start, snooze. We can see the list of emails. It made a near identical clone. They actually said what the error was. The error was from React, hydration, and time being different. If the rumors are right and Lithium Flow is indeed Gemini 3.0 Pro, are you starting to buy into the hype? Because I definitely am, and I can't wait to see this model on my Gemini CLI. But the time has come where we have to put Lithium Flow to the test with the hardest challenge yet. It is time for the 7-finger challenge. It passed it 4 out of 4 times. It got all 7 fingers right on the hand. You don't think that's a big deal? You try your large language model. It's going to get the finger count wrong. Not only is it good at fingers, but it can also tell time. So if you give it like an analog clock like this, you can see here based on the clock in the image, yes, it is a valid time, and it tells you the exact time on the clock. So I've actually tried the GTA game a couple of different times. I just can't get it to load because Alamo Arena seems to be having a lot of traffic right now. Their sandbox will fail from time to time. But on the right, we do have our Opus game, so there's that. And yeah, this looks amazing. We can shoot, and we are gaining money, and our stars are going up, and we can also enter a vehicle that we're not even near. So we become a vehicle, but you can see the sandbox for Lithium Flow is just broken, and that is an LM Arena problem. That just means you're going to have to subscribe if you want to see my code benchmark when the actual model gets released. I do a ton of different benchmarks, based on different games. I have 5 different prompts, and I benchmark it against all the other models. So if you want to see that, you want to keep up to date with AI, subscribe. It's free. Like the video if you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to like it. It tells the algorithm you enjoy this type of content and you want to see more of it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow with another AI video.
Free, just come and see at franklinair.com where you're meant to be.